Leaders' questions. I call on Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Kian Corley. Taoiseach, I welcome the statement of the Minister for Children, Charlie Flanagan, that the Government will establish a statutory commission of inquiry into the operations of mother and baby homes. And I would put it to Taoiseach that such an inquiry will have to deal clearly with how women were treated and indeed mistreated in such homes, the high infant mortality rates in such homes, the burial practices, the carrying out of vaccine trials within those homes, and all of the circumstances surrounding adoption practices, illegal adoptions, forced adoptions, and much, much more, Taoiseach. Above all, Taoiseach, I would suggest that such an inquiry will have to deal with the societal backdrop, to all of this. The then society's attitude to women who became pregnant outside of marriage. The shame, the guilt, the stigmatisation, the hardship, the culture of concealment, they were all part of society's response to women who became pregnant outside of marriage. And they endured all of that because they were deemed to have broken the rules of society. And much of that is incomprehensible to present-day generations, but it is nonetheless a reality. And children born in such homes were treated as lesser people with lesser rights, many barbarically taken from their mothers, without any real respect for their mothers or indeed for their own inalienable rights as children. And I would put it to you, Taoiseach, that the importance of that for present-day society and indeed future generations is to learn lessons and hopefully to influence present-day society for the better in terms of how it deals with the many social issues that come its way.
Question, please.
Now, Taoiseach, I'm going to put it to you that this will be very complex and very sensitive work. You will have our constructive engagement in relation to it, and I would ask that, given the sensitivities involved, and there will be many for families, for adoptees, for adoptive parents, is the Government open to consultation with the opposition parties in drawing up the terms of reference and also looking at the structure and nature of the inquiry, given the scale and the scope of what will undoubtedly have to be covered? And in the interim, Taoiseach, will the Government agree, or has the Government agreed, to establish a dedicated counselling service for all those who have been affected by experiences in mother and baby homes, be they the mothers themselves initially, be they the children, and also anyone who've had who has experienced those homes. I think a dedicated counselling service specifically available for people should be established. It will take time to do that, but it should be established to be of assistance. And immediately, I think, a confidential telephone line should be established by the Government as well, appropriately manned with appropriate personnel to deal with the undoubted queries that are going to arise because of all of the attention and the highlighting of this issue, obviously, in recent times. Thank you, Kian Corley.
Taoiseach.
I want to thank Deputy Martin for his constructive comments here. Everybody is aware the Minister for Children announced today that the Government will set up a commission of inquiry into mother and baby homes as run in Ireland in the past decade. And we do that with a sense of sadness, but equally a sense of duty and resolve, indeed. The Interdepartmental Group has commenced its work and will continue that work in terms of all of the issues that are being mentioned now for report to the Government shortly. I think this really is about, Kian Corley, a time of examining a period when women, particularly young women, were silent and were silenced. It was an extraordinary time when the women of Ireland, Manon Aheran, and poor women especially, were held up to a particularly high and callous account. It's not an exaggeration to say that their treatment in many cases and their babies was an abomination. In that regard, this inquiry will consider a time when there was, a disturbing symbiosis between church and state, where a sin became, if not quite a civil wrong, then certainly a societal offence. these were not the good old days that we were told about. These were not times of happiness or comfort for a great number of our people. And the God-fearing, respectable walls that were surrounding many sectors of society are now dismantled, and the consequent freedom and indeed the shame are ours to act with and ours to act on, and we will. I thank you for your comments made in a constructive fashion here today. The Minister for Children is quite open to full consultations with members of the opposition. This is an issue for Ireland, because if this is not handled properly, then Ireland's soul in many ways will lie like the babies of so many of these mothers in an unmarked grave. So I think it's important that we try to get this as right as possible. I take your point about counselling lines, I take your point about the structure, the scale and the scope of this, and the point that you make about counselling service. These are matters the Minister will certainly take into account. It's for the mothers and their babies, indeed for the sake of the lost and the stolen generations within families that we deal with this. And I hope that in as compassionate and as humane and as understanding a way as we can be, that we will hold this full inquiry. And the Minister for Children will see to it that opposition parties and independents are fully consulted about this, both in terms of discussions about the structure, the terms of reference, and how this should be handled. In a way, this affects the lives of so many people in our country, and has affected the lives of so many people in our country and abroad as a consequence of what happened here. And in 2014, while we seem to, in some cases, consider that this just happened in the last number of years, it is a reflection of a period since the foundation of the state, of what happened to women and mothers in Irish society. And were they poor and were they uneducated, it made it even worse. So it's not about a situation of comely maidens dancing at the crossroads. This is an issue for Ireland today to deal with another element of our not so glorious past.
Thank you. Deputy Martin. 1 minute.
Welcome the Taoiseach's comments in terms of engaging with the opposition, but also I would ask that the various representative groups and the various parties involved in this area would also be consulted. I presume the Minister will do that in terms of both the structure of such an inquiry and also the terms of reference. Taoiseach, in relation to a dedicated counselling service, just by way of information, and when we established the Commission of Inquiry into the institution, the abuse institutions, it actually took 2 years to establish a dedicated counselling service with properly qualified personnel who would be particularly adept and expert in that area of abuse. And I suspect something maybe different, but something similar will occur here. So I would appeal to you to do everything you can as speedily as possible to set up a dedicated counselling service, because many, many people who may have buried much of this or may not have been dealing with it in more recent times because of all of the debate and so on, will undoubtedly, it will create issues for people and for families. And as the inquiry begins, there will be the need for ongoing specific counselling service to be established. This would be separate from the normal counselling, in my view, is what is required, separate from the normal counselling services that may be available to people on an ongoing basis in the adoption realm. I think you need something separate and specific to be established.
Thank you.
For those who have been experienced, who have had experience of these particular homes. I also think, Taoiseach, that we owe a great debt to those historians, social historians, and in more recent times, Catherine Corliss, for example, who made the discovery around Tuam, but did so in a very measured and balanced way, actually, when you read the material that is in some of the media over the weekend, but she did come up with about 800 babies who were buried and who died in Tuam alone, in the home there from 1925 to 1961. So we're looking at a period that goes back to the early part of the last century, right up to the late 70s, if not later. So it's an enormous expanse of time. It will, in my view, have to have a number of strands to it. And I would ask you, Taoiseach, will you give a commitment on the counselling service, on the confidential telephone helpline as well, which I think should be established without any undue delay?
Taoiseach. Yes, the Minister for Children will take note of all the comments that are coming into him and the suggestions, including those two from yourself, in respect of counselling and the confidential line. Obviously, the terms of reference for this investigation are ones that need to be considered very carefully. I understand that most of the information is actually out there and needs to be collated and gone through. But I feel, honestly, Deputy Martin, this actually is a much broader question about the kind of society that Ireland that we, that our people lived in from the foundation of the state up until the early 60s. And I know from my own, from the part of the country I come from, that clearly there are implications here as to what happened to children who were fostered out, the vaccination issue, those who were forced and signed into mental institutions by families because of pressure of one sort or another, the issue of young women having been banished from various locations around the country, not to have their babies in England or in Liverpool or wherever else, if not to mother and baby homes, the mortality rates which are so high, old buildings, walls infested with TB and whatever. These are all issues that need to be drawn into the context of the kind of society that we had. This essentially is about the kind of country Ireland was, the kind of country where women in particular were the focus of shame and suppression. And I think today of the late Nuala Fennell, for instance, who served in this house here and who was principally the driver of the banishment of illegitimacy, where babies born out of wedlock were deemed to be an inferior subspecies. This is the issue, one of the issues that will be dealt with here. So I just want to say that insofar as the government and the House is concerned, this is about our country, it's about our people. It's not about apportioning blame in any one location here. We can apologise to everybody, but where does it end? This was Ireland of the 20s to the 60s, an Ireland that might be portrayed as a glorious and brilliant past, but within its shadows contained all of these personal cases where people felt ashamed, felt different, were suppressed, dominated, and obviously the question of the treatment in the mother and baby's homes is a central part of that, no more than the issues identified in the Ryan report, both about mother and baby's homes leading to the issues of institutions, fostering and all that happened there. So it's another issue, Deputy Martin.
Thank you.
That we must deal with in 2014, and to the best of our ability, we will try through the programme being put together by the Minister for Children, with the assistance of everybody, and the historians and the groups that you mentioned, we'll meet all of these in an attempt to get this as right as possible.